If you're a subscriber of my channel, you've probably seen a lot of these 12 questions that I've asked my bombshells of the month. I've had a few of you request that I answer those questions. So I actually put together 20 of the most commonly asked questions, and I'm going to answer them myself for you. So my favorite thing about my job is being able to be creative and being able to hang out with my crew, who are the most wonderful group of people and make every day so incredibly fun for me. My least favorite thing is how far everything is from me. All locations are like an hour drive from where I live, and it's just a long time to get there and a long time to get back, and our days can be incredibly long, and sometimes I'm very, very tired, and then I have to get up and do the exact same thing the next day. So what I don't love is like how long the days can be, including driving time, including like some really intense production. I've had 18-hour days before. That's not fun. My ultimate dream for the future is to have enough money where I can just shoot the kind of things that I want to and spend more time with my family. My greatest fear, honestly, is death. I hate death. It completely freaks me out. I cannot comprehend like the lack of my own existence or the lack of existence of somebody else. I look at someone that I love and I look at the spark and the light in their eyes and the idea that that would be extinguished and that they just like wouldn't be there for me one day, or I couldn't call them up and talk to them. To me, it's just like this excruciating feeling. I also hate the idea of like things just ending. It's just really, really freaks me out. So yeah, death freaks me out. If I could be any animal, it kind of depends on the circumstances. If I like had an incredibly, if I could be any animal, it would depend on the situation. If I had a situation like what I provide for my dogs, being a dog would be awesome. I live on a big ranch, they get to run around all day, they get snacks, they get love, they get to sleep inside at night. That would be awesome. But if I didn't have that option, I'd probably actually rather be a cat, because cats are so incredibly independent and they're much better at getting, like if they live in an environment that they don't enjoy, I feel like they're much, it's much easier for them to like sneak out the window and like run away and then just like live on rats in the alley and just like live their like free cat life. I feel like that doesn't really work for dogs. If I could travel back in time, I would love, this is a hard one. So I would either go to like the height of the Roman Empire. My father is a Roman and Greek scholar, and so I've always been really, really fascinated by that time. It's kind of like the beginnings of democracy, and it was like the height of civilization at the time. The technological advances that they made were just incredible. So that would be amazing. I'd also love to travel back to Elizabethan times. Queen Elizabeth I is my favorite historical figure. But in both times, you kind of want to like make sure that you're wealthy, because being poor back then was really awful and you lived in really horrible living conditions. So yeah, it would depend on, if I could be like rich, then one of those two. Okay, well, I obviously just said that my favorite historical figure is Queen Elizabeth I, so it would be Queen Elizabeth I. She's just like, to me, she's such an incredibly interesting figure. She was the first like great female monarch of England, and not the first female monarch, I know that, but the first like great, she like introduced what they call the Golden Age. She came in a time of turmoil and really solidified the country. She's an incredibly interesting figure. She refused to get married because she didn't want to give power to a man. She's just like, to me, the most interesting woman that's ever lived, and I would love to have dinner with her.
Who is your celebrity crush?
My celebrity crush is actually Edward Norton. I kind of like skinny, tortured looking men. Like, I feel like you look like you're like a starving artist and you have a drinking problem. I'm like really into that look. So yeah, I don't know. There's something about Edward Norton I'm really into. Okay, I love that. So my favorite animal is actually a dog. I love dogs because they are just, they love you unconditionally no matter what. They're always happy to see you, no matter how shitty of a human being you are, or how shitty of a day you had. They're always so happy to see you, and they run up and they pant and they jump on you. And also too, I think I have a special connection with dogs because when I was young, a little sob story right here. I was bullied a lot and I didn't have a lot of friends. And so I would come home crying from school and my dog was always there for me. And I used to like bury my head in his fur and like cry in her fur. And he was always there for me. And he was a very solid figure in my life. So I think that like imprinted on me. And so that's why I love dogs. What motivates me to get out of bed in the morning is just knowing that I'm so lucky to be living another day, that you never know when this life may end. Make the best of what you have. The fact that I have like a really full and amazing life is enough motivation as it is. And then obviously the recent addition of a daughter to my family definitely motivates me to get out of bed in the morning. Actually, in fact, I kind of look forward to getting out of bed in the morning now because usually she wakes me up because I hear her wake up in the next room. And there's nothing better than like walking into her nursery and seeing the look on her face like when she sees me the first time in the morning and she like bounces up and down in her crib. It's like, it's so exciting. I almost like race my husband to get to the nursery when she wakes up because like, you know, whoever kind of gets up first will go to her first. And if we wake up at the same time, I'm like, I got it. So yeah, she's definitely like a huge motivation for me. My greatest guilty pleasure is like probably bad period pieces. I love period TV dramas, movies. I did really enjoy Bridgerton. as bad and cheesy as that series was, I really enjoyed it. So yeah, period pieces, I love them.
What is your secret talent that your fans might
not? What is my secret talent? Oh, I think I know. My secret talent is nobody matches me in delivering a compliment sandwich. So a compliment sandwich is when you give somebody, I wouldn't say an insult, but maybe like constructive criticism, and you like put a compliment before it and then the criticism and then a compliment after it, so that like when you deliver it to them, they're like, this is a delicious sandwich. It's not really any kind of criticism of me. Yum, 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 yum. I feel like I'm really good at that. The one thing in the world that I would like to change, God, there's so many things, but I think probably the most pressing thing, the thing that affects all of us, all the animals on the planet, is global warming. That shit's scary. There's been some really crazy weather changes, hurricanes, earthquakes, water shortages, famines. It's kind of bleak. So yeah, if we could try to, you know, be more responsible as humans and take better care of our planet, that would be, I think that'd be the best thing that we can do. The greatest lesson life has taught me is that you can achieve anything. I've had some pretty hard times in my life. I've been through some things that I never thought I would ever recover from. Anybody who knows me knows that I was like a severe alcoholic, and I actually conquered that twice. I got sober for 7 years, I relapsed, I got sober again. I've been sober for like 3.5 years now. And those were like the darkest times when I didn't think I was gonna be able to get sober again, and I did it. And it really made me appreciate life and appreciate what a gift sobriety is. And it gave me a sense of gratitude that I don't think I ever had before. So yeah, maybe the lesson is actually gratitude. I think that's the lesson. The greatest lesson life has ever taught me is gratitude. My biggest pet peeve is that when people constantly make excuses for their behavior and make no attempt to change it, that's really annoying to me. So somebody who likes to say, oh, it's because I'm this way, oh, it's because I'm this way, and doesn't do anything to try to modify that behavior, and just continues to repeat the same mistakes over and over again, I find that really irritating. You know, when I was drinking and, you know, every day I was like telling myself, I'll be different today, I'll be different today. And, you know, I know that I was in a constant loop of making the same mistakes over and over again, but I was constantly trying to do something about it. I went to meetings, I went to rehab, I went to sober living. Like, I did everything that I could until I finally got it. But people who make no moves to change the things in their life that is holding them back, that bothers me. What makes me happy is family. I'm so incredibly blessed to have an amazing family. We're all really, really close. And now that both my sister and my brother have had babies, and I obviously had a baby, now like we all have kids together, and getting together at Christmas and holidays is just like my favorite thing. So for me, family is definitely the one thing that makes me really happy. My hobbies. Man, I used to have hobbies, and you know, now that I have a baby and a job, it's hard. It used to be boxing. I loved that. That was like a big hobby of mine. I would say that my hobbies are reading. When I have a chance, I love to read. My hobbies used to be traveling before I had a kid. So yeah, I guess right now it's really just reading. If a fan sees me in public, should they approach me and how? It's so funny because this question I actually reserve for like the really famous porn stars that I interview, because that happens to them a lot. That fucking never happens to me. I wish it would happen to me. It would make me feel really, really important. It actually only happened to me once on the Santa Monica Pier like 10 years ago, really, really randomly. So yes, come approach me. Make me feel special. Yeah, just come up and say hi and say that you love my work. And if you want to take a picture, I'll totally take a picture. And, you know, I never get approached by fans, so I'm definitely not jaded by it. So I will be very receptive to you. What's my idea of the perfect first date? So I'm married, so I'm not going on any more dates. But I think me and my husband's first date was pretty good. We went to dinner, you know, had a really good meal, got to know each other. He walked me back to my car. That was enough, you know. Maybe a dinner and a movie if we want to prolong the night. But generally, you know, I don't want to be out that long, that late with somebody that I just met. Maybe keep it shorter. Kind of makes the anticipation for the next time I see you more enjoyable. So yeah, just like a casual dinner is good for me. Who are my biggest creative influences? Well, I think, you know, my mom. I would have to say, I mean, you know, anybody who knows my mom, Sus Randall's work, and knows my work knows that, like, they look very similar. I learned everything that I know from her, so I think that there's no denying that she's my greatest creative influence. I also, it's funny, my favorite photographer is Ellen von Unworth, but my content doesn't really look anything like hers. Her stuff is very kind of spontaneous, often in black and white. It's very like lively and vivacious. My work's a little more like controlled and colorful, but I love her work. Where would I like to be 10 years from now? I would like to be kind of in the same place that I am now. Surrounded by my family, doing a job that I love, feeling healthy and happy, and just grateful for everything that life has afforded me.